It was a rough night for many people in Australia yesterday. Oh. I mean, in some places it kicked in sort of mid-afternoon, but for those in New South Wales, by late last night, it was all go.
But don't you think, at 3:30, this dark pall just came over the sky. We had baths and showers early and jumped into our jammies and just watched
not
it.
Not together, obviously.
Yeah, not together, definitely.
All right, let's find out what it's like on the street for people who have got out of the bath, out of bed, and are standing around Gabrielle Boyle, our reporter, who is experiencing the full force of the wind still, Gabrielle. As the sun comes up, people obviously are going to be able to survey the damage, if there is any, in their own properties.
Yeah, and there is quite a bit of damage, let me tell you, just coming out to the cross. We've got trees out everywhere, leaves all over the streets. It's just looking pretty ugly at the moment, and the grey skies aren't really helping. We know that ferry services in some areas still aren't operating because it's just too choppy. The airport has reopened as of 6 o'clock. That was closed overnight because those winds were in excess of 100 kilometres an hour out at the airport itself. The SES have had almost 1,000 call-outs for help. We've had trees down, trees on roofs, roof damage, and a little bit of localised flooding, and it's expected to continue into today. It won't be as bad as it was overnight, but those east coast areas right on the beaches are the ones that are going to feel it for the next few hours.
No rain here in Victoria, but still plenty of flooding to be concerned about. The SES now turning its attention to the coastal Gippsland towns of Lakes Entrance, Painesville and Locksport. The Army has been called in to help sandbag some key infrastructure like hospitals and schools, but at this stage authorities still not sure how bad or widespread the flooding is going to be. To other news, and thousands of students are preparing for their final day at Mowbray College. The private school is some $18 million in debt, and last minute talks to try and keep at least one of the campuses open have failed. VCE students will be able to stay at the school until the end of the term, but for students from prep up to year 10, today will be their final day. The doors are going to close at 3 o'clock this afternoon.
Good morning from Adelaide. We've got a good one for you this morning because the City Council has decided it wants to tackle litter. Now, folks at home, let's have a think. If you were going to tackle litter, what would you do? Quick think. Now, did you say put in more bins? Congratulations, that's a really good answer. But you're not thinking Adelaide style. What the council's decided to do is paint 45 of those bins pink so that people can see them better, because they did a study saying that, and it came back and people said, oh, we can't see the bins, so pink. But on top of this, what they're also going to do is paint motivational messages on the ground so that people that are thinking of littering will look down, see a nice little sign saying, please don't litter, and hopefully that will solve the problem.
Good morning from Brisbane. Disgraced former surgeon Jayant Patel will front the High Court this morning as he appeals his manslaughter conviction. Now, in 2010, he was sentenced to 7 years jail for the manslaughter of three patients while he worked at the Bundaberg Base Hospital. Now, his appeal all centres on the jury being instructed with the wrong criminal code. In other news, there's a big birthday celebration in Queensland today. In fact, Queensland turns 153 years old and basically everyone's invited. That's except basically Sydney and Melbourne. Adelaide, Joe Hill, you're more than welcome to come along, buddy. And you wouldn't be a Queenslander unless you had a gripe. Today's gripe centres on the latest tourism campaign. The complaint up here is that there's not enough Queensland beaches featured in it. The problem is that one down in Adelaide people just aren't happy with.
Oh, that's not fair. The Adelaide one I think was of Kangaroo Island, the beautiful pristine beaches there. But your
fantastic.
Beach has got a bit of a run. They look stunning. Lizard Island, the Great Barrier Reef, gorgeous.
I think there was three featured, but the guys want a few more apparently.
I can understand that, Jonathan. Do you feel just a little bit jubilant today? Because of course it is Queensland's day today, isn't it?
Well, it's supposed to be a big day, but there's no real festive activities set up in the heart of the CBD this week, so it's really kind of going unnoticed, guys. We might head around later and have a bit of a chat to people, but
that would be a good idea.
Under the carpet, perhaps.
Yeah, is it because Campbell Newman just wants to? And goodness only knows, Queensland does need to save money. What, $85 billion in debt?
A fair bit.
But you can still afford some candles or something, can't you? Is it Campbell Newman's just said no to spending any money on yourselves?
Party police.
He's cut back on the balloons, the helium. There's going to be no high-pitched voices, no fun.
All right. Now, I think we need to go back to Joe, if he's still there in Adelaide, with the whole bin idea. So painting motivational signs on the footpath and painting them pink, what about just fines, like in Singapore or Hong Kong, where you get busted big time for, you know, discarding your chewing gum on the footpath?
No. That would be too mean. As I said, you're not thinking Adelaide style when you're coming up with actual practical ways of getting people to stop doing things. It's they did a study, and people that were littering said that they couldn't see bins, that there weren't enough bins around. They took that and they said, oh yeah, right, that's just an excuse. So as I said, what they've come up with is the bins will be pink, so that there's no excuse for not seeing the bins.
Look out, you're about to be taken out. Yeah. Look
now,
out.
This is ironic because they're actually replacing
them. There.
The thing is, though, Joe, is this a joke? Do they seriously have that many bins in Adelaide? Do people in Adelaide have that much rubbish that you have to have a bin every 10 feet?
Well, I mean, I didn't really think the litter problem was too bad. There are stretches where
there's nothing,
you know, there's
in
not
them.
Heaps of bins, and well, you know, that's
Jono,
the thing.
Hey, Jono, why don't you ask this guy what he thinks about them going pink?
What? Hey, lads, what do you guys think about the litter situation in Adelaide?
Oh, we're gonna clean it up.
They've got to clean it up. So anything we can do to make their lives easier, heck, they're all for it.
Well, I don't think you're making it easier by putting in another 50 bins. But anyway, it's all very interesting, and I can see by the smile on your face, Joe, that you think that it's ludicrous as well. You're
well,
a local.
Because they're not putting in more bins. That would be sensible. All
they
they're doing
they
is they're finding 45 bins that they've already got and painting them pink.
See, here's the problem. If they've only got 45 bins, they've got about 20 of them
in that one
area. People aren't going to carry their rubbish to that one spot to throw it away. Anyway, thank you, Joe. I think we've exhausted any kind of
Absolutely.
Conversation.
And go and wash your hands. You touched that bin way too many times for my germ liking.